The continuous attacks and killings in the crisis involving Junkun and Tiv people have continued. The crisis, which began in Kente village in Wukariloku government area, the southern part of the state in April last year, has now spilled to 7 councils. The latest violence is taking place in Bali and Gashaka councils of the central zone of the state. Governor Darius Ishaku and his counterpart in Benue State, Samuel Ortom, have not been able to stop the killings. Death tolls in separate attacks on communities yesterday rose to 17. Over 240 residents were displaced and their homes razed. A police spokesperson, David Misal, confirms the attacks and killings. In Maigoge settlement of Bali Council alone, witnesses said 4 persons were feared killed, 2 others were gunned down, and dozens wounded in Ananum and Akate areas of Donga. Caretaker chairman of Bali, Mahmoud Musa, confirmed the killings in Maigoge. He also confirmed that an 11-man peace and reconciliation committee has been set up in the local council to ensure there is a ceasefire. We now have social commentator and security expert Kwanim Terence joining us. Thank you very much for your time.
Thanks for having me.
A reconciliatory committee has been set up to, you know, try and manage the crisis in that state. What are the missing elements that is allowing this crisis to continue to blossom?
Yeah, I think the genesis of the crisis within the Benue Valley is far beyond the peace and reconciliatory meeting that was set up, because we have a people that have consistently laid claim to the Benue Valley, and we have a people that have consistently insisted they must graze their cattle within the farms of the people of Benue, Taraba, and Nasarawa State. Now, it becomes very difficult reconciling them to be on the same page with the decision of the Peace and Reconciliation Committee, because it is a group that have gone to public domain to insist that they are going on to graze wherever they want, and the security agencies have failed to apprehend them and caution them. So they are like a people who have immune to be causing crisis around the country without anybody cautioning them. And you and I know that this thing has already escalated to the deep south, and it has become a very serious issue. As we speak, within Benue State alone, we have crises that have consumed about 32 people in the last 5 days in Kwando local government, in Obi local government, in Guma local government, in Gwewes local government, and in Agatu local government. As we speak, the night of yesterday, we woke up this morning having 7 cops on our hand. So the attack has been sustained. And if we recall, on Tuesday, the Miati Ala Katon Hore came out in public domain to do a press conference and told the whole world that with the sustained attacks they are having on communities, they are also going to form a security network that will go around harassing Nigerians that are attempting to stop their business. So it is a challenge why the federal government is not apprehending the people who are perpetrating these crimes. Because when people die, they come out boldly to tell the world that people died because they rustled their cows. These are communities that have no history of rustling cows. So we keep wondering how you are going to rustle a cow when you cannot herd a cow. So it is quite strange what is happening. And we already know that with the scenarios that are taking place, these things are beyond the Peace and Reconciliatory Committee.
Okay, so are you saying that this has gone beyond the state government, that it has to be a decisive action from the federal government?
Yeah, already the state government has little to do about this crisis, because the state government does not give directive to police commissioners. They take directives from IGs of police. The military people that are on ground takes directives from the chief of army staff. The SS personnel, the civil defense, they take directives from Abuja. The president is the commander-in-chief. So until the president gives a decisive directive to his service chiefs to be able to apprehend those people who are causing mayhem within the Nigerian communities, it is going to be difficult. The Peace and Reconciliation Committee set up by the Benue State government was simply to address issues of communal crisis between Benue indigenes. It had nothing to do with the crisis that are attacking Benue from outside by the Fulani herdsmen. So that what happened in Makurdi was just the communal crisis that were happening between Benue community. It had nothing to do with the serious issues that people are losing lives. So the major security challenges that we are having within the Benue Valley can only be addressed by the president, who is in control of the service chiefs.
What are the options for resolution there? Because you're painting a picture of very dire circumstances that's making it seem like we're caught between the devil and the deep blue sea. Give us an idea, a way out of this quagmire.
The solution to the Fulani and Herders farmers crisis is for Fulanis to ranch their cows. Once they ranch their cows and they are not going into people's farms with the animals to destroy the crops, there will be peace. And you and I know that the best global practice of every animal is to ranch. So it is strange to us that they are refusing to accept the best global practice of rearing animals. And then two, they keep complaining of attacks of rustling in the bushes and attacks by wild animals. So why will you be given an alternative to escape from all those crises in the bush, and then you are saying no, and rather attacking communities?
All right. Thank you very much, Kwanim Terrace, for your insight on the matter.
Thanks for having me.